Now, the Philippines assures the United States it does not support unlawful killings as the death toll from the Duterte administration's war on illegal drugs continues to rise. The Foreign Affairs Department issued the statement on Saturday, a day after the U.S. Embassy in Manila said $32 million in aid from Washington must be used to promote human rights. The U.S. also reiterated its concern over inappropriate and unacceptable comments by President Duterte against outgoing U.S. Ambassador to the Philippines, Philip Goldberg. Now joining us this morning to weigh in on Philippine-U.S. relations, we have former career diplomat and Senator Leticia Ramos Shahani, who headed the Senate Foreign Relations Committee at one point. Good morning, Senator, and thank you very much for joining us.
Good morning, Gigi. Well, you're in the neighborhood, or I'm in the neighborhood.
I'm so glad that it was easy wonderful. For you to come here to the studio. Well, I'm very interested to get your views. I'll go straight to the point. Is the Philippines, our relations between the Philippines and the U.S., headed for stormy weather? Last week, the U.S. expressed its disappointment over two issues. The first, extrajudicial killings in connection with the war on drugs. The second, the inappropriate comments made by President Duterte towards the outgoing ambassador, Philip Goldberg.
Well, I'm glad the ANC is interested in what is specifically a language issue. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, after all, whether he likes it or not, President Duterte is our chief diplomat in the country. Okay. He's not only the commander-in-chief of the military and the police, but he's also our chief diplomat insofar as our relations with other countries are concerned.
So what does that mean?
Well, he has to be careful about every word he says, whether he likes it or not.
Okay.
He cannot just say, ah, nagbibiro lang ako. Mm-hmm. In maybe in diplomacy, wala yung biro-biro eh. Everything is sort of seriously taken. So diplomacy is a linguistic career. And so as a diplomat, you are trained to be careful about every word you say, especially to the country to which you are accredited.
Well, the words of President Duterte towards Ambassador Goldberg were certainly inappropriate. That's the view of many people. But having said that, he also said that, well, Goldberg sort of threw the first punch when he involved himself in when he intervened in what was basically a domestic affair. He intervened during the campaign period. He made some comments about the inappropriate joke that was made by President Duterte. Do you think that, you know, you were a former career diplomat? Do you think that what Goldberg did, commenting on essentially what he should have stayed out of, was that appropriate for him?
Well, he should not have really said anything about during the election time, mm-hmm. because you know, that's a very sensitive issue for us. And whether we like it or not, there is really a love-hate relationship between America and the Philippines. And that's because of the power inequality, the money inequality which we have. And that will go on for several years. So we have to learn how to live with it. Mm-hmm. But we need each other, as I think I told you earlier. Obama has said that we are their pivot in Asia. That is true. They need a pivot badly at a time when China is rising as the new superpower of the world. And America is also, I won't say declining, but if you watch the Trump-Clinton fight, there's accusations that, you know, we have to make America great again. And so there is this inequality where we really need each other, and we need America now to help us against China, because really our Philippine Navy is so nakakaawa eh. Mm-hmm. I mean, China is now building its third aircraft carrier, and in the Philippines you only have motorized bangkas as part of our Coast Guard. So we are really we're not in that class to fight China. Mm-hmm. And we need Japan, Australia, the United States, and all of our allies to help us in this transition period, where I hope we shall eventually have an independent foreign policy this is what I'm really hoping for.
Well, you said that we need each other. It's a love-hate relationship between the Philippines and the U.S., but President Duterte has also said in previous interviews that he thinks that we're better off making friends with China than the U.S. He said this in an interview not too long ago, mainly saying that in the first place, he doesn't think we need to pay too much attention to, I'm paraphrasing it, but he's saying that we don't really need to put that much effort in strengthening ties with the U.S. because, number one, the U.S. isn't really threatening the Philippines anyway. We're already in good relations. So he's thinking that we need to focus more on strengthening ties with China. And number two, he says that, well, we're not part of the Trans-Pacific Partnership anyway, which means that we're better off really strengthening relations with our neighbors, China, Japan, etc. Is that a wise policy or position to take where you prefer to strengthen, to focus your efforts strengthening ties with one country over another?
Well, you know, President Duterte has created new spaces for us. The NDF, Communist Front, is a new space. Foreign relations is a new space, you know, with the decision of the arbitration tribunal. So we have some aces in our hands. And so the president must learn how to play poker quite well. He does not have to give away signals right away, you know, like using all this gutter language. I'm sorry to have to say it, because I hope the best for our president. I want him to succeed. But he has to be careful about language. And really, he has used gutter language insofar as Ambassador Goldberg is concerned. Ambassador Goldberg, as the U.S. ambassador, is the highest ranking official here. He has his letters of credence from President Obama saying to the president of the Philippines that he is our representative, he represents our country, he can negotiate for us. Mm-hmm. So because of that, he has to be respected in the same way that we want our Philippine ambassador in Washington, D.C. to be respected. Diplomacy is a two-way process, you see. It's not just a one-way street.
Having said that, our Philippine ambassador in Washington likely would not have made any comments during the campaign season.
Well, fortunately, we have no ambassador now. You know, Mr. Quija left. Mm-hmm. He was Pinoy's ambassador to Washington.
Or the chargé d'affaires, for that matter.
But we have a chargé d'affaires who really does not, luckily, because he did not respond.
So meaning there's no opportunity for them to have a misstep the way that Ambassador Goldberg did
here in the Philippines. That is correct. Mr. Quija is back home now, back to his old job, I understand, with Film Life. And so we just have a chargé d'affaires who can say, oh, I was not aware of this situation, you know, in a diplomatic language. But The president is still the chief diplomat of the country, whether you like it or not. He's also the commander-in-chief of the military and the police. So it's a very powerful position, and that position has to be used with some care and to avoid police gutter language, especially you're talking, Gigi, to a feminist, and rape is really no joke.
That's right. Well, earlier you mentioned the sorry state of our armed forces the armed forces of the Philippines. But, you know, the Philippines and the U.S., it's been said so many times over and over again that the U.S. is our closest ally. But when it comes to strengthening our ability to defend ourselves from external attacks or from internal attacks, do you think that the United States has really demonstrated that it is our closest ally?
Well, you know, in the Mutual Defense Treaty, where it says that an attack on both at both sides will need the response of the other ally, really, if we are attacked by the U.S., there is no guarantee yet that we see, although Obama has said in his last Malacanang dinner that agreement is ironclad, mm-hmm. whatever that means. Mm-hmm. You know, it's all semantics. Mm-hmm. But the best answer to your question is that we have to learn how to defend ourselves, mm-hmm. because no one else will. The Americans will naturally want to defend themselves. No American soldier mm-hmm. will want to be killed in the Philippines, though the Philippine-American relationship during Bataan and Corregidor is something enshrined in our history, and it has been tested by time. Whatever gutter language is said sometimes withstands the insults.